The simplest and basic kinematic chain is a 4-bar chain or quadratic cycle chain as shown in figure. In this figure, it consists of 4 links and each of them forms a turning pair, that is total 4 turning pairs A at A, B, C and D. When one of the links of a kinematic chain is fixed, that kinematic chain becomes a mechanism. If you fix different links of a kinematic chain, then you will get different mechanisms, and these all are called inversions of a kinematic chain. Now if I fix AD, then you will get one inversion of this 4-bar chain. This link is fixed link, and the link opposite to this fixed link in a 4-bar kinematic chain is called coupler. Now this link is called coupler. So any link which is just opposite to the fixed link is called coupler. Now other two links are either called crank or rocker, depending whether these links can have a complete rotational motion or not. If AB can have a complete rotational motion, then it is called a crank, or otherwise if it is only oscillating, then it is called a rocker or lever. If you fix AB, you will get a different mechanism. And in this particular case, which will be the coupler, the link which is opposite to the fixed link. So this link is fixed, so opposite to this fixed link is DC. So this DC is a coupler, and these two, BC and AD, these two will be either crank or rocker. So this will be crank or rocker. Similarly, you can get other inversions also. Now here I am taking one example. Here this black link is fixed. Now this green link is having complete rotational motion, therefore this green link is called crank. Now this link is just opposite to the fixed link, therefore this is a coupler. And this link is only oscillating, therefore this one is a rocker, or you can say it is a lever. Now Grashof's law states that in a planar 4-bar mechanism, the sum of length of shortest and longest links should not be greater than the sum of remaining two link lengths if there is to be a continuous relative rotation between two links. If you want a rotational motion, at least one link is rotating, then it is necessary that the length of shortest and longest links should not be greater than the sum of remaining two link lengths. Now in this particular example, this one is, I assume that this one is smallest length, this link is having smallest length, this is having largest length, and other two links are shown, intermediate links are named as P and Q. So according to Grashof's law, this L plus S should always be less than equal to P plus Q. Now when L plus S is less than P plus Q, it is called a class 1 mechanism. And then depending whether S, that is smallest link, is connected to the ground by one end or two ends or no end, the mechanism has the following types. If smallest link, one end of the smallest link is fixed, then you will get a crank rocker mechanism. If both ends of the smallest links are fixed, then you will get crank mechanism. And if none of the ends of a smallest link fixed, then you will get rocker or double rocker mechanism. Now what about if L plus S greater than P plus Q? Then this type of mechanism is called class 2 mechanism. And in this type of mechanism, you will never get a rotational motion for any of the links. So always you will get only a rocker mechanism or double rocker mechanism. Now let us take some examples. I have taken one example where link lengths are 5, 6, 7 and 9. I have drawn one configuration. Here this length is 5, this is 6, 7 and 9. Now smallest length is 5 and largest is 9. So smallest is 5, largest is 9 and other two intermediate links are 6 and 7. So if you check L plus S, 9 plus 5, 14, which is greater than 7 plus 6, 13. So this is a class 2 mechanism, and therefore whatever link you fix, if you fix AD, then AB and DC will act as rocker, that is lever. If you fix AB, then BC and AD will act as rocker. If you fix BC, then AB and DC will act as rocker. And if you fix DC, then AD and BC will act as rocker. So always you will get double rocker mechanism in this particular case. Now, second example where length of links are given 5, 7, 9 and 10. So, in this particular case, smallest length is 5 and largest is 10. So, smallest is 5, largest is 10 and intermediate links link lengths are 9 and 7. So, here L plus S is less than P plus Q. So, this one is a class 1 mechanism. Now, I have drawn one configuration. Now, if I fix one link, if I fix AD, so if I fix AD, then you can see that smallest link is AB. So one end of AB is fixed. So I have explained that if one end of the link AB is fixed, that is one end of the smallest link is fixed, then you will get crank rocker mechanism. So here this link is fixed. So this will be coupler opposite to this fixed link. BC will be coupler. Where AB will have complete rotational motion, that is AB will act as crank and DC will act as rocker. Now in second case, so this will be a crank rocker mechanism. Now in second case, I am fixing second link, this AB. If you fix AB, then you can see that this is the smallest link and both ends of the smallest link, A and B, both ends are fixed. And therefore, you will get crank-crank mechanism. So here you will get crank-crank mechanism. So this link is fixed. Opposite to this link, that is DC will be coupler and BC and AD will act as cranks. That means BC and AD both can have a complete rotational motion. BC can rotate, you can rotate BC by 360 degrees. Similarly, AD also you can rotate for 360 degrees. Now in third case, I have fixed this third link PC. Now again, you can see that one of this smallest link, one of this end, so B end, and B is fixed here. So again, you will get the same case, crank rocker mechanism. If one end of the smallest link is fixed, then you will get crank rocker mechanism. So again, you are getting crank rocker mechanism. And in this mechanism, this link is fixed. So therefore, AD will be a coupler and AB will act as a crank and DC will act as rocker, that is lever. Now, fourth and last one, this is the fourth inversion. So here I have fixed this DC. Here you can see that smallest link is AB. Now none of the ends of this smallest link is fixed. So therefore you will get rocker-rocker mechanism, that is double rocker mechanism. It means the link which is opposite to the fixed link, that is AB, is a coupler. Now other two links, BC and AD, these two links can oscillate only, that is they act as a rocker only. Another example is length of links 4, 6, 7, 9. So here you can see smallest link is 4, largest is 9 and intermediate links are 6 and 7. When you check for this relation, then you are getting L plus S is equal to P plus Q. Now in this particular case, it is similar to class 1 mechanism. I have drawn this and here this one is the shortest link. And same method, the rule of shortest link, that is if one end of this link is fixed, then you will get crank rocker mechanism. Both end of this link is fixed, then you will get crank crank mechanism. And none of the ends of this shortest link is fixed, then you will get rocker rocker or double rocker mechanism. Now the special case when two sets of links have same length, that is two links of 4-4 length and two links of 9-9 length. Here smallest link is 4 and largest link is 9 and other two intermediate lengths are 4 and 9. Here again you can see that this is L plus S is equal to P plus Q. This is a special class. Now in this two configurations are possible. One configuration when two same length links are connected together, here AB and AD, these are of same length and these are connected here. And similarly BC and DC, these are of same length 9 and they are connected at C. So this type of mechanism is called deltoid 4 bar mechanism. When you fix here, the same rule, the smallest link rule can apply, you can apply here also. That means if I fix this length AD, now out of AB and AD both are smallest link. So here both ends of the smallest links are fixed. Therefore, you will be getting crank crank mechanism. So this is a crank crank mechanism where BC acts as coupler and AB and DC both act as crank. If you fix second link AB, again this is the smallest link, both ends of the smallest links are fixed and therefore again it will act as double crank mechanism. So this will be your coupler now, DC. Now BC and AD both act as cranks, that means both will have complete rotational motion. Now if I fix this link, in that case you can see that one end of the smaller link, this is the smallest link, and out of the in this smallest link one end B is fixed, and therefore you will get crank rocker mechanism. Now in this crank rocker mechanism, this will be your coupler, and this will act as crank, and this will act as rocker mechanism. Now if I fix DC, now again you can see one end of the smallest link, this is the smallest link, so one end, that is D, is fixed, and therefore again you will get a crank rocker mechanism, in which this link is the rock, this link is the coupler, and this AD will act as crank, and BC will act as rocker. In deltoid 4 bar mechanism, one link will always be a crank, sometimes both links will act as cranks. Now second possible configuration here is, here the smallest link, this same links are not connected together, these two are same length links, these are not connected together, similarly these two are same length links, these are not connected together. This mechanism is called parallel crank 4 bar mechanism. Now this is a special class. In this particular class, whatever link you fix, every time you will get double crank mechanism. That is, if I fix AD, you will get AB and DC as two cranks. If I fix AB, then you will get BC and AD as two cranks. If I fix BC, then again AB and DC will act as cranks, and if I fix DC, then again AD and BC will act as crank. So in all the four inversions of this parallel crank 4 bar mechanism will be double crank mechanisms. Thank you.